can say that it's been demanding, it has been stimulating, and it has been motivating. I must say my whole perception about Africa has been changed, and I'm in a position where I feel more empowered and more inspired. What I like most about being in Addis and ECA, I think the work environment has been quite accommodative. I've enjoyed working with my colleagues. They've been very supportive and very encouraging. So it made the whole work environment quite easy to handle. I must say that I'm very honored to have worked with the first woman to ever had such a large institution. And there are quite a lot of things that I've learned from her through observing and through her mentorship. First thing, I learned that to run such a huge institution, you need to have a global mindset. And there are core qualities that I could pick from her. I learned that you have to have integrity, you have to be sincere. Excellence is one of the qualities that I learned. And the other one that was more important was that she empowered a lot of people. So for me, it stood out the best. Generally, to some extent, I believe that some have been fulfilled. Of course, there are areas that I feel, well, I think they need more work or they need to be improved. But generally, I think they have been fulfilled. One thing that I realized when I came here was that most of the leadership positions were filled by men. So it's one thing that I realized that even the madam herself took it up, and she has made some, you know, initiatives to ensure that she will encourage other women to hold not only lower positions but higher positions, so that when she leaves here, they will take over. So that's mentorship and empowerment. Besides the gender disparity issue, I think one thing that needs to be done is the... Okay, there's a lot of working in silos that I've come across in ECA. So if divisions could be encouraged to work together closely, such that people in different divisions could know what the other ones are doing and how what they are doing impacts their day-to-day work, I think ECA could go far as a think tank, and it will be able to deliver its objectives more efficiently. Yes, I'm looking forward to going home, but I will miss ECA because the environment has been very different from where I come from. So at least there are things that I'm taking back to them about being in ECA, so I'll make sure that I share that with them. And already I've started encouraging some of my peers and colleagues to make use of the program, such as Mo Ibrahim Foundation Fellowship Program and other programs that are out there for the young Africans. I'm going back home and going back to my old job. But I think one thing that is most important for me that I want to do is I want to go for PhD. So that's my next move. And while I'm still looking for other options, I think I'll be doing my PhD.